I know as a viewer, it was a roller coaster of emotions watching because there were fun moments and there were really heartbreaking moments. Were the two of you able to shake that off when you kind of stopped working for the day or when you were done shooting the whole season? Or did it really stay with you for a while? Because these characters go through a lot in a short period. Well, not it's not a short period of time, but for you guys, it was, you know, in your filming.
Yeah, there was definitely days that, like, I think me and Daisy were quite good at, like, having as much crack as we could possibly have. But there is days when you, like, because the longer you're shooting, the more you're kind of falling in love with your character and who that person is. And when they're upset, inevitably you, it's just a little bit harder to shake it off. And I think the predominant thing was having worked so closely with Daisy and the crew and everybody for 5 months to then, once we finished in Italy, it was like, okay, bye. But that was a weird thing to adjust to. But nothing out of the normal. Like, I didn't go to a very dark place after the shoot finished or things like that.
Yeah, I mean, I think that, like, I think I'm still sort of, those characters are still sort of with me in some way because I love them so much. And you know, it's interesting because that final scene that we shot was actually shot a year later. In a pickup, and it was really interesting when we kind of did that because I felt a year older and I felt like I was sort of, well, I was a year older, but I also felt that I was kind of, because I grew up so much during that job and learned so much about myself and stuff that it was interesting to kind of do that final scene a year later and kind of say goodbye to them. But yeah, I mean, I think just like Paul said, like we were kind of playing those characters sort of every day. And then going home, reading the chapters, reading the script, learning the lines for the next day. So obviously you were kind of, you know, you were in it so much that just like your body doesn't quite know what, that it's not actually you when you kind of come to set and you're crying all day or you're like playing yeah. and stuff. So definitely at times you'd kind of go to bed and be like, but at the same time, like Paul and I were quite different to Marion and Connell. I think though Marion and Connell do have a laugh together, they are probably a bit more serious than we are. So we would kind of be able to, we were giggling most of the time and then we do serious acting and then we go back to giggling. So yeah, it was a mixture.
That's good. And the whole season, there are so many, there's big confrontation scenes. There's very intimate scenes. Then there are scenes where you guys are just looking out a window or just observing something quietly. Which was more challenging for you as actors? Because sometimes just being still and quiet can be tough. But what did you think? What was the toughest challenge, I guess?
Interesting, because I totally agree. I don't know about you, Paul, but I found that stuff that where you didn't have to say anything, where you were just kind of existing, very tricky. Because I think, I don't know, it's interesting when you're in conversation like we are now, there's an element of performance because you're trying to get across the way you feel about something. Whereas I don't really know what I'm like on my own, like when I am just kind of not thinking about, you know, communicating something or whatnot. So I guess as an actor as well, you're constantly trying to communicate something to the camera, to the other person in the scene with you. So when you're on your own, just reading a book, you're a little bit like, I don't, am I acting like I'm reading a book? Or like, you know, it is actually quite hard. So I probably found those moments that were dialogue free the hardest. But actually, I think when you watch them, they're really powerful. And I think that it's amazing kind of editing that you can kind of get these little moments that I probably didn't even know I did, like a little eye thing or a breath that you kind of really kind of translate something to an audience.
Do you feel like if Connell had just asked Marianne to that dance that everything would have been different, or do you think their lives were going to still play out the way they were going to play out? I know you're getting razzed about this.
What do I think, first of all, the series would be far less interesting, right. Second of all, I don't know, they would have found some way to be at odds with each other, but I think he, for the record, he should have asked Marianne to the dance. It's really hard to know. I think something else would have cropped up that Connor would have had a shit attack about and not been able to do. So, yeah.
Okay. That was the right answer. Daisy, let me ask you, you know, people are really fascinated with Marianne's family life. And for you, what was going on with the brother exactly? Because I feel like it was, in some ways, it was very subtle, but also very real, where things aren't always said, but you can imply a lot. But what's your take on what actually was going on there? Because he clearly had big issues with her.
Yeah, I mean, I think that was something I sort of talked about a lot with Lenny before we started filming, which was really interesting because obviously it's a little bit different than in the book. I'd say it's probably, he's less awful actually in the series than he is in the book. In the book, he is really, he's very harsh, and he, you know, there's a moment where he squeezes water on her head, And in the book, I think he spits in her face. So it's like, it's a lot more subtle. And I think that our reasoning behind that was because obviously, you know, it's interesting that when you're reading a book, you obviously get your character's perspective on something, and therefore it's always ultimately going to be biased. And so you're not allowed that, really. You're not able to do that so much when you're in a series form, because you have to actually see these characters interact with Marianne. And I think we discussed a lot about, like, I think Aisling, who plays Denise, and Frank, who plays Alan, are amazing, really, because they brought so much kind of nuance to those characters. Like, for example, sort of Denise, there's some really beautiful moments with her that you feel like, I remember I read a quote that was describing it as like scar tissue. And I think you really do feel that with both of them, that there's a massive amount of history that's gone on in that family. And Marianne says to Connell that her father used to hit her mother, and he asks if he ever hit her, and she kind of says no, but you don't know if that's true. And then I guess Lenny and I would, sorry, my lighting's gone a bit interesting, but Lenny and I would discuss like whether, look at that, I'm having some strobes going on. Lenny and I kind of would discuss about whether perhaps the reason Denise is so kind of cold with Marianne, and she talks about Marianne having it easy, is perhaps, you know, Alan as her older brother was perhaps abused by the father as well, and maybe Marianne wasn't, and therefore there's a maybe guilt there from Denise about the fact that Alan had such an awful childhood, and Marianne sort of, I guess, even though she didn't, because she obviously witnessed that stuff, perhaps she wasn't physically harmed, and therefore, you know what I mean? So I think that was really interesting to actually, that was some of the stuff I am really like proud of, and think was really wonderful about sort of the adaptation, is being able to explore those characters a little bit more, because you're able to see the way that they are with Marianne, and also what's going on internally for them. So yeah, that's sort of my take on it, if that answers your question.
It does. And I kind of like that it wasn't clearly spelled out exactly what was going on, because families are complicated, and it's not always just a quick answer. It's, like you said, scar tissue and years of that. I know I want to see more of these characters. Is there talk of another season? Are you guys doing, do you know anything? What's happening?
There's nothing that we know of, or yeah.
Would you guys like to get back in these characters' shoes and see what the next 5 years are for them?
Yeah, I'd absolutely love to. It'd be insane to say otherwise, but unfortunately, like, it's not our decision. But also, I would be totally comfortable to leave them be, because I think the book is quite final in a certain sense, and but the selfish kind of actor part of my head is like, oh, I'd love to play Connell again and again and again and again.
Yeah, I agree. I think like a little bit of me is quite happy that there is no sort of neat tying of the end, in that like they're still very much alive and existing in the world, and I don't have to say goodbye to them, because I know there's life afterwards that maybe I don't know about, which is quite nice.
Okay, well, I'll keep my fingers crossed. As a selfish viewer, I would like to see more, so we'll see if that happens. Thank you so much for chatting with me, though. Congratulations on really great work, and I'm glad the response has been so great for you guys.
Thank you so much. I hope you have a lovely day.
Yeah, you too. Thanks so much. Thanks. Bye, guys.